इस पुण्य स्थल में आते हुए मैं सबसे पहले भगवान श्री रामचंद्र को प्रणाम करती हूँ, शारदा माँ को प्रणाम करती हूँ और स्वामी विवेकानंद के आत्मा को और स्पिरिट को प्रणाम करती हूँ। मंच पर उपस्थित पूज्य स्वामी निखिलेश्वराज जी महाराज, जिनके प्रयत्न से, आग्रह से और ख़ास करके आशीर्वाद और प्रेम से मैं यहाँ उपस्थित रही हूँ। पूज्य स्वामी बलभद्रनाथ जी यहाँ रामकृष्ण मंदिर के उपस्थित सभी स्वामी लोगों को मेरा प्रणाम। आज मंच पर उपस्थित डॉक्टर नितिश कुमार पेठानी, सौराष्ट्र यूनिवर्सिटी के वाइस चांसलर, डॉक्टर सुनीता सेनगुप्ता, डॉक्टर शाह जो वडोदरा से आए हैं, श्री शरद सुगरिया, डॉक्टर विनायक लोहानी और श्रीमती ज्योति बेन धनकी, आप सब मान्य और विद्वान यहाँ बैठे हैं और आज उपस्थित राजकोट के मान्य बहनों और भाइयों और विद्यार्थीगण और दूर दूर से आए हुए इस राष्ट्रीय सम्मेलन में उपस्थित सब। स्वामी जी ने मुझे कहा था कि ये नेशनल सेमिनार है तो आप हिंदी में या इंग्लिश में बात करिए तो ठीक, ज़्यादा ठीक रहेगा। सो आई स्पीक टू यू इन इंग्लिश। आई थिंक एक विधि का विधान था कि जो मैं यहाँ पहुँच गई। बहुत बहुत आदरणीय वक्ता आपके सामने आने वाले थे, हमारे राष्ट्रपति आने वाले थे, फिर आदरणीय हमारे गवर्नर श्री, मुख्यमंत्री श्री, सबके लिए स्वामी जी ने बहुत प्रयत्न किया, पर कुछ होगा भगवान की इच्छा जो आज मैं यहाँ आपके सामने पहुँच गई। इन 1893 स्वामी विवेकानंद, अ यंग मंक फ्रॉम इंडिया, traveled all the way to America, Chicago, and changed the thought and the thinking of the people of the world. America was the youngest democracy at that time and the youngest nation. Par jab wo wahan pahunche, hamare Bharat se, he said, I thank you in the name of millions and millions of Hindu people of all classes and sects. Unhone ek hi vakya mein sabhi logon ko isme, pure vishw ko isme le liya. Hamare sab us samay aap sochiye ki pura Hindustan was under the British rule. We had lost our confidence, we had lost our power of thinking. I am a student of history, so I always like to relate to history when I'm talking to something. So historically, where were we at that time in 1893? And at that time of depressed India, when Swamiji left, he left with all the courage and reached this new land where he was a nobody, where people didn't know who this young man and this monk is. They didn't know anything about Hinduism. They thought Christianity is the best religion in the world. They didn't know anything beyond that. And at that instance, Swami Vivekananda reaches there, and with God's grace, he gets the opportunity to speak. And he just changes everything in the audience, but he also changed everything for us. We got a pride of our nation. We got a pride of our religion, and we felt proud of being Hindus. We felt proud of being Indians. So that was the courage he gave us. And that is the lesson he taught to the whole world. That Hinduism is a religion which has never conquered anyone. We have never fought wars. Jitne ladai hue hai hamare pure vishwa mein, hamesha religion has been behind it. All the wars have been fought on the base of religion. And of course, you know the World War II, when the Nazis were against the Jews. Hitler ne jab ladai ki, World War II, World War I, all was fought with the sense of religion and to get the better of the other person's religion. Aaj hamara ek Hinduism hai, jo kabhi kisi ke upar vishwa mein bahar jaake ladai nahi ki. We have never fought wars on religion. We have welcomed with open arms everybody who came in the name of religion also to our country. We were just welcoming everybody. Right in the ancient time when the Jews were prosecuted from Romans, Swamiji kehte hain unke speech mein, tab South India mein unko ashray diya. Jo aaye unko ashray diya. हमारे देश में वहां से Zoroastrians को भगाया गया तो सभी पारसी लोग हमारे देश में आके हमसे घुलमिल के अभी भी आज हमारे लिए हैं यही हैं. So ऐसे परिस्थिति में we welcomed one and all. So that is the strength of our religion. That is the strength that everybody comes and it is assimilated in us. So this such an important fact, which the world didn't know, he introduced at the World Parliament of Religions. And I think that is what made us so proud. Us, the Indians, who were under the rule of the British at that time, they could lift their head with pride and they could feel that, no, we have done. He gave infused courage, he infused confidence, he infused so many good things for our country too, but also for the world. And that is the lesson we need to take from Swamiji's historical speech at the Chicago World Parliament of Religions. It is 125 years, but why are we talking about it today? Is it not relevant today? आज के परिस्थिति में भी जो उन्होंने उस समय कहा था वो अभी भी उसका मतलब हमको समझना चाहिए. I remember निखिलेश्वर राम जी महाराज जब वो बड़ौदा में एक दफ़े आए थे अभी recently for this only, and he said if everyone had heeded Swami Vivekanand on 9/11, maybe in America wouldn't have had the 9/11 again and still remember. You saying that the 9/11, when the Twin Towers were hit and broken, it was exactly how many years ago on the 11th of September that Swamiji gave his first address, when he said that we want harmony and peace with everybody. That is what Hinduism has taught, and that is what the world needs to listen. They need to listen. Even that 9/11 was done only for the sake of religion, unfortunately. It's so sad. And still it's going on. Aaj bhi uska relevance kitna hai. Today also we are going on. Just recently in Sri Lanka, 2 months, 3 months back, how many Christians were just massacred in a church on Sunday morning? Wo bhi religion ke naam se hi hua Sri Lanka mein, Colombo mein hua. I mean, these things are still going on. So we are not listening, we are not thinking, we are not thinking of what Swamiji had given to the world. And Swamiji, what he said. He said, I'm proud to belong to a nation which has sheltered the persecution and the refugees of all religions and all nations of the earth. I'm proud to tell you that we have gathered in our bosom the purest remnants of Israelites who came to southern India and who took refuge with us in the very year in which their holy temple was shattered to pieces by the Roman tyranny. And then he says later on, but the time has come to ring the death knell of all fanaticism and persecution with the sword or the pen. We have to stop that. Uncharitable feelings between persons wending their way to the same goal. Ek dusre ke liye sadbhavna rakhein, that we have a harmonious feeling. This is what Hinduism has taught us, and this is what we have to follow, and this is what we have to still convey to the world, hoping that it will change one day. We are still hoping, aren't we? Abhi bhi hum log hope hi kar rahe hain, kyunki abhi bhi hamare आप देखिए क्या हो रहा है दुनिया में इन द वर्ल्ड व्हाट इज हैपनिंग स्टिल इन द नेम ऑफ रिलीजन ऑल द टेररिज्म इज गोइंग ऑन देयर इज नो स्टॉपिंग टू इट एंड दिस इज सो इम्पोर्टेंट आई थिंक दैट इज व्हाई दिस 125 इयर्स ऑफ सेलिब्रेशन ऑफ दिस शिकागो स्पीच ऑफ स्वामी विवेकानंद एट द वर्ल्ड पार्लियामेंट ऑफ रिलीजन्स इज so relevant and more important today than it was ever before. That is what we need to learn and take back from here. So that is what I would say to you, that this is important. In his words, also for me, there is also another personal link which I cannot not speak about, that 40 years later to 19, this date when Swamiji spoke, 40 years later, somebody who was born in the same year, Swami Vivekananda and Maharaja Sayajirao were born at the same year. And we celebrated the 150 years of both these visionaries and great souls in the same year. That is also, I should say, a coincidence. And 40 years later, I think we can all feel proud, in 1933, on the 27th of August, Maharaja Sayajirao was invited to give the presidential address for the Second World Parliament of Religions in Chicago. Today, 86 years later to that date, in the month of August, same month, I stand before you today. So it gives me a certain emotional connect with all what had happened. That is why I need to mention. Maharaja Sahib, when he spoke, he left the audience spellbound, they say, at the Second World Parliament of Religions. I think he also took his words and he took his, prepared his speech in thinking about what Swami Vivekananda had said 40 years ago, And he said, I'm deeply sensitive to the honor you have done me in calling upon me to open this great conference. It is, I think, a tribute to my ancient mother India, truly a grandmother of all religions, he said. He called it the period a great time to be alive. In 1933, this was spoken. We are in an age of ferment and chaos, but also of transition and awakening. We need a change of soul. This is true not only in India. Science has united the world, but it has divided us socially, economically, and politically. This is what Maharaja Sahib said at that time. But don't we see it? Science has, this modern technology has brought us so close to the whole world. But haven't we lost something in keeping relationship with each other? Isn't the technology taking too much of us? I need to tell the young people that. I want to tell you students that don't let it become a demon in your life, that tomorrow you forget to talk to each other because you are so busy on your smartphones. People are sending messages to the whole world, but they can't talk to the man who's sitting next to him. That, unfortunately, is what we need to remember. And this was said in 1933. Did we know that technology is going to take us over so much today? Please pay heed to it. I especially tell the young people that don't get lost in your smartphones. Please listen to the man near you, listen to the people near you, listen to your family, listen to your friends. Today is World Friendship Day and people are sending messages all over. But go and shake hands with your friend. That is more important. He said at that time, man has become smarter. Can he become more decent? Can he rise to the new set of values? Can he weigh and analyze the furthest planet? We have reached to Chandrayaan, has reached now the moon. But can we organize our own lives? That is more important. Main inhi shabdon mein aap sabhi logon ko Swami Vivekananda ne kaha tha, harmony in peace is the need of the hour and not dissent. That is what he had said. That is what we need. We need to feel warm and good to everybody that we meet. Hamare desh mein we have remained back only because hum jatiwad se nahi uth sake, hum dharms ke upar nahi uth sake. This has been our weakness. This ye hamara kami rahi hai. So jatiwad ke upar to humko nikalna hi hai. That has been the problem. At that time, Maharaja Sahib in Baroda tried to give education to every class of society, to the girls, to the untouchables. Us samay jo untouchables kehte the sabhi ko. Unko shikshan dene ke liye utne bahut prayatna kiya. Ye hum 1901 ki baat kar rahi hu, jab unhone khas karke jo pachhat varg ke logon ke liye hostels khole aur shikshan dene ka prayatna kiya. Isi sandarbh mein आप जानते हैं कि बाबा साहेब अंबेडकर महाराजा सयाजीराव ने भेजा सिर्फ मुंबई में नहीं उनको ग्रेजुएशन के लिए स्कॉलरशिप दिया बट ही सेंट हिम टू कोलंबिया यूनिवर्सिटी ही सेंट हिम टू द लंदन स्कूल ऑफ इकोनॉमिक्स फाइव टाइम्स ही गेव हिम स्कॉलरशिप एंड टुडे दिस इज द पर्सन हु रोट आवर कॉन्स्टिट्यूशन ऑफ इंडिया आई मीन हाउ व्हाट इज द फॉरसाइट ही हैड सो आज हमको इस सबसे ऊपर निकल के हमारा देश बहुत महान है आवर हिंदू रिलीजन इज इवन ग्रेटर देन दैट सो दैट इज व्हाट टीचेस अस to take everyone as a brother and sister. We take everyone in our fold. Sabke saath sadbhavna, prem ki bhavna rakhne ka, yehi seekh humko hamare samvidhan se bhi mila hai, aur hamare bhartiyata se bhi mila hai, aur hamare dharma ne bhi humko yehi sikhaya hai. So isliye, I thank you all once again for having me here. I'm sitting in very learned company. Bahut vidwan log baithe hain, main to isme nahi hu, phir bhi ek aatmitya se aap logon se mulaqat hui, so I'm really very happy about it. So I thank you all. I thank Swamiji and all the monks who are present here today, sabhi swami logon ko. Itna hi ishwar se prarthna hai ki sabhi ko sukh shanti aur swasth acha swasth rahe aur hamare desh jaise hum chahte hain us tarah pragati kare. Dhanyawad aur Jai Hind.